咱们欠低息利用，咱们叫 silent shop， 咱们的币都开了，咱们对比 ，Amazon， 咱们 Nike，WeHear， 咱们跟另外 Paris Johar， 咱们跟 Tree， 咱们 Happy Sample。And on that, for example, number two, this one alone. Number three, passive study. Number four, on dream home. Number six, another tiny comment. Number eight, that's new rule. Number 20, moment two. And number 22, NGD. Team from Kazakhstan. Number one, Bakhtet Lawrence Goy. Number two, Bogdanovich Sultante.Number three, Halab Thomas. Number six, Dawlet Ben Aliye. Number seven, Dalim Dan Aliye. Number eight, Abhinya Dov Dasby. Number nine, Bakit Ben Kajimov. Number ten, Norgan Francis Ryan. Number 11, Norlan Abu Talibov. Number 13, Mutami Hansi Bayer. Number 14, Murat Yeshmanov. Number 16, Norlan Omerza.Number 17, Alisher Bucky. Number 18, Yellow St. Ferrier. Number 19, Nick St. Hellier. Number 23, Old Sun Oyestar. Coach for Singapore, Mr. Solomon Tsuji, and for Kazakhstan, Andre Yushchenko. Our umpire today, Mr. Tao Sunan from China, and Mr. Muhammad Ramli from Malaysia.
Welcome to the Sengkang Hockey Complex, where, of course, it is the Men's Hockey World League that is taking place. It's round one. The women's event will be taking place as well over the next 8 days. We've got games for all coming your way.
The first one will be
to catch all the great action. But first, as with all international events, it's time for the national anthem. to get through to the next round, of course, when the ranked teams do participate. They will come in a little bit later on as well. China are the highest ranked side here. China ranked 18th in the world at the moment, 6th in Asia. Now, as Kazakhstan, who Singapore are taking on today, they're relatively new to the sport. They are ranked 76th in the world. From a playing point of view and for the players.
Good evening, Paul. Basically, this is a new team for Singapore, and they are rebuilding a new team from the SEA Games. Been training for a couple of months, and this is a platform for them to test the new players so that it can go to the next level.
Well, it'll be interesting to see if they do. Of course, they lost out to Malaysia in the final of the SEA Games just last year. A 2-2 draw after regulation time, which of course is 70 minutes, and then losing 4-3 in a penalty shootout was heartbreak for Singapore. So it will be Singapore in the red strip that will get us underway, kicking from right to left. Wherever you're joining us, a very, very warm welcome. It's hot, humid and sticky here in Singapore. As getting us underway straight away is Ashraf. Nicely played forwards and a nice little turn, but just impeded there. Abu Talapiyov just getting a little bit too close. So a free hit for Singapore. Enrico Marcian looks to get into the D. Clash of sticks, play continues. Tassanov helps it forwards, but it's dispossessed. There's Sabri Johari. Michi Yong drills it forwards. Good stick work there from Timothy Goh. Michi Yong. Strong, solid defence there, no? But Singapore still looking to attack. Well read on that occasion. And well brought out. Abu Talipov managing to get himself in the way. That's a lovely ball scoop forwards as well. Sansabayev looking to get on the ball. They are relative newcomers, aren't they, Kazakhstan? So it may take them a little while to settle down, not?
Yes, Paul. It looks like they are adapting a zop and long counter attacks. Yeah, and so far they are doing well in defense. They are quite compact, and they are doing pressing, low pressing.
And, of course, vitally important, particularly for these new sides. We've already seen some big results today. 7-0 and 7-0. Thailand beat Brunei. Sri Lanka beat Myanmar. And a 7-goal deficit as Hong Kong defeated Vietnam just a little bit earlier on. Well taken there. Sansabayev does well and wins the free hit. Short corner. Big call from the referee there.
Yeah, it was it was a push from a Singapore defender.
Tao Tianan and Ramli Mohammed are the officials, the official umpires for this one. And now it's Singapore that find themselves on the back foot to the unfancied Kazakhstan. Tazanov with the drag flick to the edge of the D. save in the end from Suresh. Coming to knock clear. Yellow, and a real opportunity. Another good save from Suresh. Fantastic goal from the keeper on that occasion. Not once, but twice.
Thank you. Thank you. The half time. I mean,
how many?
5 minutes.
I'm gonna try to bring the game down from the time because once they pick, there's the time will be long.
The open side. in and he took the yard. And having been up on the cross for the first 15 minutes, Singapore have managed to fight their way back into this game.
Of course, a well-lit goal.
Just asking.
let's go direct. You want to go direct, right?
Test 1 2.
1 2 1 2 1 2. I'll be going about this level. Bloody blah 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 blah. 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2. I'll be going about this level.
Go 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 go.
One two, one two, one two. We have just under 5 minutes to go until the second half will commence. Should be
test 1 2.
1 2 1 2 1 2.
Testing.
One, two.
Testing 1 2.
Okay. Okay. 1 2 1 2 1 2. Okay, we're good to go.
Good.
Okay, check.
Thank you.
That's why you can't hear.
No, I'm just
it's just in case it's being streamed there.
Sorted out during the break.
A very warm welcome back wherever you are. Thank you for joining us here on Fox. We are bringing you the Men's Hockey World League Round 1 from Singapore that currently sees 3-0. That does Almen. A lot of it's about body posture as well and body positioning, isn't it, Nordin? About making sure your opponent can't get to you or the ball.
Yes, basically now they allow us to use the body to protect the ball. Other than you move back pedaling with the ball, you are not allowed, but you can move sideways and use your body to be in between the ball and the opponent. So they took advantage of this.
Well, we've seen that in the games that we've seen so far tonight. It's a lovely port all forward, so unfortunately Singapore couldn't make the most of it. So here come Kazakhstan again. Sansabayev. A little bit of a pinball moment there as Hafiz tries to go forwards. It's Hafiz again. Just keeps it simple. Tanu doing ever so well. Ball fired in, deflected. That's going to be.
It was a foot.
Another short corner. Singapore's second of this match. Let's not forget it was Kazakhstan that had 3 early on in the first 15 minutes. The Singapore finally got themselves back into the game. That's where they started to impose themselves.
Singapore need to be careful giving the easy turnover because Kazakhstan is waiting for the counter attacks.
Selassie will be with the drag flick. That was cool, but a good save again. Sasin Bauli doing ever so well to get in the way.
The flick was too direct to the goalkeeper.
Unfortunately there, the foot was used as well from Faris. And a big scooping pass forwards, easily dealt with. That's going up above head height, so the hit awarded in favour of Singapore. Nice play and a lovely little touch there from Abdul Hanif. Just concedes possession again. That's something at the start of this period that they're doing. They're getting the ball better, but they're not using it as well as they did.
Yes.
And Nice ball tucked up the line. Tassanov. Nice ball held in, but behind, so that's going to be a hit in. So Singapore looking a lot more comfortable and starting this half better than they did the first.
Yeah, they are starting better, but I'm not don't really understand why they are slowing down the game. They should like pick up the game and like, you know, press on the other side, and because Kazakhstan is not afraid of attacking.
Good play there from Jaspal Singh, who gets on with it quickly. Fired in, and unfortunately Timothy Goh just couldn't get on the end of that one. Better from Singapore, and that was the quick injection you were talking about.
Yes, exactly, that's the one. And they should do this high press and not let them go out of their half. This rule with this high stick is quite unique, because nowadays they allow you to use the high stick, and depending if you are there first, then you will have that advantage of that stopping the ball, not the defender or the opponent.
Well, the rules are such, and the way that hockey rules have evolved over the past 10 years have made it one of the fastest, most exciting games to watch now, as we're being so near by Kazakhstan, who turned defence into attack very quickly. However, Singapore cut it out and drilled it up the other end. A lunging challenge means that one goes out of play. Getting on with things quickly, Ashraf keeps it simple. A little flick back inside for Faris. Hanif. Here they come again.
One more
then.
Time, yes.
Yeah, they're not afraid to have a go, are they?
They are allowing them to have a counter attack.
Tanyuru doing ever so well. Jaspal fires that one into the centre of the park. Good touch from Sabri. Drew forwards, Silas with the touch. Well, we saw him with a couple of fantastic touches in that first half. Just not the same on that occasion.
No. And the delivery, the balls, as I said, mentioned just now, some of them, they don't need to raise the ball. And you should just give a flat, simple, early ball.
There it is. Silas. Just the swing out to try and get on the end of the ball. Gets penalised. Sansabayev battling hard against Jaspal. Lovely turn from him. And he's got an option for Zalmen. Suresh had to come a very, very long way. The ball hitting the foot. But that is that quick counter-attack. Very, very quick counter-attack.
Very quick counter-attack. And Singapore shouldn't allow them to give that direct ball in the center channel, which will result to this quick counter-attack.
Sansabayev looks the pick of the crop, though, doesn't he? Nurkan Sansabayev, the number 10 for Kazakhstan. Very lively.
Lively, and I think probably he's the focal point for this team.
Seems to be a little issue for Suresh. Seems to have been sorted now. Well, the adage in most sports is who would be a stopper, who would be a goalkeeper, but at least here they have the protection of the padding, so that helps them a little bit. Suresh now, okay. A little reverse pass means that Sabri has to get back in there to defend, and does well.
Good play, good return ball by Enrico.
A mistake though from Tanyuru. There's that high stick that was raised, but with the new rule, allowed. Jaspal helps it forwards. Tanyuru wins the hit.
This is the one I don't really understand, because our reaction after a turnover is very slow, and they allow the Kazakhstan defenders to come back and defend in full numbers. They should have a quick turnover and attack.
Yeah, but I know what you're saying. Kazakhstan aren't afraid to do that. They just get on with things extremely quickly. So that's scoot forwards. Well read, though, from Lee Chi-yong. And now it's Singapore's turn to attack. The options are there. Malakan just feeds it into Hanif. Hanif couldn't just control it. Just want to win it back, though. Good tricky play once more from Anik. Another one who looks lively for Singapore, given a little bit of time and space.
If you notice, Kazakhstan has changed some of the attacking tactics. They are scooping the ball more frequent now.
Just to relieve the pressure, you would think, more than anything. There's the ball drilled in. It just have been a little bit too high and dangerous, so the whistle goes. Which means the Kazakhs can have a little bit of respite. And what do? They give it straight back to Singapore. Malakan does ever so well. It's Malakan! What a brilliant finish that was! Well, the skipper leading by example. He picked up that loose ball, went past players like they weren't there. And Singapore now have a healthy 4-goal lead.
That was a very good skill and a very good goal from Enrico.
Defense from Singapore there, and there is the man of the moment. You have to say, a sublime finish from him. Almost as good as Faris's goal, because Faris dribbling it all the way into the box and around three or four defenders that were closing him down. I'll let you debate that one late in tonight to see which one gets the best goal award. Here he is again, though. Malakan just pulled it behind the run of Silas, and the wasted opportunity is now gone. More action all the way through the next 6-7 days coming your way. Tomorrow there are some very interesting games there, particularly in the ladies group as well. A bit later on, the Singapore ladies will go into action here and get their campaign underway against Sri Lanka. There's that big scoop again, and again the comfortable control, the high stick on that occasion from Alman, adjudged dangerous. Malakan can come forwards again. They look so much more comfortable compared with that first 15 minutes, don't they?
Yeah. They look more commanding second half.
There was a lot of pressure on them going into the game. However, they are going to have to defend here. Easily dealt with by Lee Chi-yong.
However, they need to be careful, because Kazakhstan is quite tricky and dangerous when they have the ball in the circle.
Well, they might be looking to the fact that Myanmar and Sri Lanka are in this group. Sri Lanka, of course, winning 7-0 earlier on today. Singapore, well, they drew 1-1 with Myanmar in the SEA Games, so they can't afford to have another reoccurrence of that one. A little bit of a shock to the system that was, as well, as Singapore went in red hot favourites. However, they did manage to come away with the silver medal.
Sansabayev. Well marked, and that's a really good defending from Li Chiyong. On the foot hit, so Malakan can get on the ball and get things going again. And Jun Hong helps it into the middle. Easily picked off though. Malayev working overtime in that defense for Kazakhstan.
Singapore team, I think, need to step up because it seems that they are slowing down the attack and they're slowing down the pace, which will favor the Kazakhstan. That's what they want. They are, you know, used to a slower pace. The first few goals just now when Singapore scored, because the pressure was constant, and then Kazakhstan's defense cracked.
Still plenty of time left in this half. Just over 18 minutes to go. Singaporean team happy to stroke it around. That's much better. Silas just tried to jink his way through but couldn't, so Norman Tio concedes possession.
Too many turnovers.
Is that what you would look at to analyze this game? You see the turnovers, the amount of times that
exactly,
that's happened?
Exactly. If we use statistics to improve on our games, if first half we turn over, we lose the ball, say, 20 times, maybe second half we should reduce, maybe 5, you know, we'll make mistake, but we should reduce. But it's the same like in the first half. Too many turnovers. Another one.
Well, gifted turnovers as well, which is the thing. And in tennis, they're called like an unforced error. Like you say, people do make mistakes and they can be forgiven, but when it just seems simple to stroke it like that, 5 meters, that's why the stats don't lie. Nice little touch and turn in the middle from Tanyiru. Chaz Powell fires it into Hanif. Tanyiru again, nicely helped on, looking for the run on that occasion of Ashraf. Tanyiru, that's a lovely turn.
He has to run the ball 5 meters before he can send the ball into the circle.
Well, there's the little advantage from that high lofted ball, and a chance now for Sansabayev. That's good defending. Very good defending from Jaspal Singh. And he got away with that. Hanif. Miscontrol, but finally wins the ball back after losing it again.
Sometimes I feel that Singapore teams, they hold the ball too long. When you see now, the Europeans, the Australians, they pass and go, pass and go.
Just overplayed on that occasion. A little bit too far from Faris. Means that Kazakhstan can go in search of a goal. Oh, there's a big mistake and a little trip from Hasif. Sansabayev with the ball in. Not enough blue shirts getting forwards though.
Yeah, I think basically they're pumped up, and I think they are just going to wait for the attack, and probably they will just attack with 2 forwards and the rest are waiting in their half.
I wonder if they may have a couple of injuries as well, which is why they haven't changed any of the 11 so far throughout this match. That's a lovely, mazy run from Faris. pretty similar to the goal that he scored in the first half. Here he goes again. Into corner, which of course is now taken from the corner line.
Long corner, yeah.
A little bit of time and space. Unfortunately, you can see there, Jasper wanting it in front. The pass was behind from Hafiz. Very good play from Almen. And we are going to have a green card.
So what we call that a spoil tackle, where you cannot get the ball, so you block the player along the way. That's the reason he get the green card.
Sansabayev with the ball in. Wrong corner.
I used to bring the Singapore team to Malaysia to play some games, and we had only about 11-12 players who can really play, and 4-6 of them reserve. That's why during the game we don't really change all, because when we change they will make a lot of mistakes, and you know, because of they are new. So maybe because of that, Kazakhstan is doing staying with the 11.
Well, they are a developing nation in this, and the referees called that one early because that was great stick work from Silas. There were five red shirts looking to go forwards, even though they're down to 10 men. And that looked like the foot of Ashraf. Got away with it, though.
I think he gave him the advantage because there was nobody 5 meters around him, so advantage can be played.
That's good officiating to try and keep the game going and flowing, and that's exactly where other sports could learn from hockey. There's Silas again, jinking past everybody, fires it in. You could see what he was trying to do, Ashraf, there on the turn.
That would be a very nice goal if he connect the ball.
Singapore again now in control. Nice ball played inside. Norman Teo wins the hit. Jasper. Solid defending. Zoldas by having to track all the way back in there to win the ball back. It's a lovely ball played back in, but once more Ashraf couldn't control it quickly enough. Well, these two sides are going to have a little bit of time to think and ponder before they take to the field again. That will be on Tuesday. Kazakhstan will take on Myanmar. So that could be a battle at the basement, which means it could be a very big game with Sri Lanka taking on Singapore. Sri Lanka winning 7-0 earlier on today. That may give us who will top Pool B.
That would be a game to watch, Singapore and Sri Lanka.
Well, the foot being used, and you could see both players full out there. It really is high, intense stuff. Here he is again. Sansabayev doing ever so well. You do feel, though, fatigue starting to creep in a little bit. There's the little nick. Well defended on that occasion from Ahn Jun Hong. Marakan doing well. Marakan again tries to find the angle and sticks flying around, and that's going to result in a short corner.
That's what they wanted to look for. They were looking for the short corner earlier because they couldn't get a clear shot at goal. And it's a good plan.
It's only their second one of the half, only the third of the game. They've now equaled things up with Kazakhstan. Well, the last one wasn't too bad. Sarsen Bawali doing ever so well in goal, having to be forced into a save. Will he be called into action again? Again, they've gone to Silas this time for the drag flick. There you go. It can be as simple as that. A great, great finish. Sabri Johari makes absolutely no mistake. Singapore lead by 5-0.
What a goal. Textbook goal. He does it, this drag flick, every time during the training.
So finally, Singapore get a goal from a penalty corner. And that proves that the pressure is counting.
They should get more penalty corners because I have seen them practice and the conversion rate is very good.
Well, they've got to keep pushing and that's exactly what they're doing. Silas, nicely down the line, a little stumble back to Silas. Well, felt entitled to take the shot on from the edge of the D. Just pushed his shot wide.
Usually the kind of shot, we will ask them to take a diagonal shot because if he misses the goal, the left side player will deflect the ball in. Or if the goalkeeper tries to stop the ball, the rebounds, we can go for the rebounds.
Manakan doing well once more. Hanif. Jaspal. Sabri. Oh, Lee Chi Young finds himself well up the field of play. Hanif gets away with that one. Getting away with the playing off the legs. So all hands on deck now for Kazakhstan. Marakan down the line, pulled back in, and another one now, another short corner. Well, you asked for them to push for more, and that's exactly what they seem to be doing, Nordin.
Yes, they should. They should get few more goals because Kazakhstan, I think they are slowing down and they are practically walking.
It looks as though it's going to be the same sort of routine. Selassie with the ball. Sabri! Well, exactly the same, but just wide on that occasion.
It was not a good, not perfect trap, so he has missed the angle.
Here comes Singapore again, Malakan.
Misunderstanding between Marikan and Timothy.
Yeah, you could see Timothy go just acknowledging that. Well, mistakes and tired legs in the Kazakh camp. Not exactly what you're saying, though, about how it was when you were a coach, and you've got to try and keep your best players on for as long as you can. And that seems to be exactly what Yushchenko is doing. Marakan doing well again, forcing his way into the D and forcing the short corner. So just under 5 minutes to go. Singapore aren't going to lose this game. The question is can they add to the tally that they have already? They've already scored one from the short corner. Can they get another one?
I'm sure they can if they can get another few more short corners. And
well, let's see. Selassie will be with the drag flick. That's well worked. It's just unfortunate on that occasion, and he just couldn't guide that into the back of the net. Yep. That was a good mix-up, though, from Singapore, but now they're having to defend. That's a lovely touch, though, and very, very well played at the back from Lee Chi-yong. Slight variation on that one. Tsantsabaev just winning the hit. Been a lot quieter this half as the service hasn't got to him like it should have done.
In the first half, yes.
Again from Lee Chi-yong, who does well to get his body in the way as well. Silas retains it. It's a nice little touch and turn as well from Annie. So that's Bay. Well, you could see the size difference between the two players. However, so that's Bay couldn't keep it in play. It's a lovely ball into Marakan, who has acres of space. Silas. Nice turn from him. Good solid defending. It needed to be as well from Aliyev. Marakan. Lee Chi-yong. Oh, bodies all over the place again as Singapore tried to scoop it home.
And it goes.
Goal number two for the skipper. Marakan, the right place at the right time. Singapore getting closer to the seven mark. Well, seven seems to be the magic number today. 7-0, 7-0, Thailand against Brunei, Sri Lanka against Myanmar. A seven-goal spread as Hong Kong defeated Vietnam by 8-1. Is there time for one more for Singapore to make it a clean sweep of seven in this, the final Pool B game of the day? That's a lovely touch from Silas. Sasimboli having to come a very, very long way to deal with that one.
Singapore players are asking for a penalty corner because the goalkeeper sat on the ball. Okay. We are just looking for the penalty corners now to score the other goal.
Can they get it? Marakan on the hat-trick. That's impatient, you would say. He wants the three.
Yes, I think in this crowded area, I'd rather have a practice corner than a shot at goal.
Tsantsabaev almost in. Booted away in the end. Well done from Almen. Tasanov, who hit the post in that first half, who went really close. Tasanov is still Tasanov. Tasanov! Waited too long. Tsantsabaev pokes it just wide. That is a huge let-off for Singapore. That should really have been a goal.
Yes. To be fair, the Singapore team's marking a bit poor this second half.
they are going to have to book their ideas up a little bit for Tuesday when they will take on Sri Lanka. Dangerous play, the whistle goes, that's going to bring an end to the match. But we do have to say, Singapore, after what turned out to be a dodgy 15 minutes at the very start of the match, thoroughly deserving this 6-0 victory.
Yes, they played much, much better after the first goal. And well played.
Three goals in each half then, very, very comfortable. Ashraf getting things underway with 27 minutes on the clock before Timothy Goh scoring 2 minutes later. Faris with a brilliant individual effort made it three before half-time. In the second half, a double from Marakan meant that Sabri goal from a short corner gave them their three in the second 35 minutes as well. So the full 70 minutes was completed. Kazakhstan gave a great account of themselves for the first 15-20 minutes, but it's Singapore that power their way to victory. They win and will take the points in Pool B at the Sengkang Hockey Complex. They defeat Kazakhstan by 6-0.